Welcome back, and we are coming to you live from Nashville, Tennessee. Tremendous crowd on hand. They are on their feet as we prepare to take a look at Chris Benoit as he faces Squire Dave Taylor, who will be teaming up with Lord Steven Regal, the luck of the draw, working for Regal and Taylor as the Belfast Bruiser gets shipped out, shipped back to see his physician. He is all busted up as a result of a match that took place here on the parking lot a couple of weeks ago, and Taylor the man to answer the call. And by the way, guys, you were watching WCW Saturday night and studying this. I mean, you saw Diamond Dallas Page. What's up with that? The benefactor? I mean, this guy's like a canker sore that keeps coming back. Every time you think it's gone, it comes back. This time he's got somebody with money behind him.
Well, who is it, Heenan? I don't know, but somebody must know something about Diamond Dallas. There must be something there that keeps driving this benefactor to keep bailing this guy out. I don't know. I don't have an answer to it.
I've got an answer. Go get some penicillin for that rash.
Well, they found a loophole. He got himself an attorney, a limousine, a whole new outfit, and he is back. We'll be talking more about that. We'll be talking more about Chris Benoit, the Taskmaster, Slammery, and all the action coming up right after this. Time out. All right, welcome back. We are live. We are into the thick of things here. Chris Benoit, the Canadian Crippler, a man who is afraid of no one and a man who can take anybody out at any time. This guy is triple tough. Just ask Arn Anderson. Just ask the Taskmaster. They've been in the ring with him. They know what he's all about. And he is one intimidating individual. He's fast. He's crisp. He's clean. And he knows a lot of ways to hurt you. He didn't get that name, the Crippler, the easy way.
No, he didn't. I'll tell you something I admire about this man. You know, they selected him to be a horseman because of his ability in that ring. But lately, he feels that maybe Arn Anderson's getting a little soft. He has no feeling at all for Kevin Sullivan, the Taskmaster.
I disagree with you. He's got a feeling for him. It's just not a good one.
No, it's not a good one. You're right. It's down deep. But you see him when he go talk to Kevin Sullivan. When he talked to Arn Anderson, he got up in their face, and they both took a step backwards. They both took a step backwards because of this man, Chris Benoit, got up in their face and told them exactly how it was. He is not a man to be pushed around.
He is arrogant indeed, Mongo.
Well, let me tell you what. They better get over that quick, because isn't Benoit and Kevin Sullivan tag team partners?
I don't think they really care.
No.
I really don't think they care. Well, European uppercut there by Dave Taylor.
And is it just my imagination, or did when Benoit step up in Arn Anderson's face, he kind of stepped back a little, didn't he?
He didn't kind of step back. He very definitely stepped back. And Anderson, no doubt about it, one of the tougher guys in WCW. Oh, good old-fashioned boot to the face. And that's what happens when you telegraph a move. Hey, I want to say hello to Hulk Hogan, who is, I'm sure, watching his good buddy Shaquille O'Neal tonight. Orlando Magic, Atlanta Hawks, in game four. I'll tell you what, it's do or die for the Atlanta Hawks tonight, following WCW Nitro on TNT.
I understand the Belfast Bruiser had to go to the hospital. He still had glass in his eye. He refused to go. I guess he went up the other day to the office of the WCW, caused a big commotion, turned over desks and tables and everything. They are making sure he goes to the doctor. He's out of the lethal lottery right now, but he didn't want to be. He is one tough customer.
Yeah, he was carrying so much metal from that parking lot mash left over from those cars around the parking lot. He had a hard time getting through the metal detector at the airport.
Those Irish eyes weren't smiling. They were furious.
Not. They were not.
Well, you know Regal's happy about not having him for a partner. Those guys would have ripped each other to pieces before the match even started.
Big European uppercut forearm by Squire David Taylor. And I tell you what, that'll rock your world in a hurry.
Oh.
Double sledge coming off the ring apron. And again, we understand, we talked about Diamond Dallas Page earlier on, and I want to point out that hard work Bobby Walker, he got hurt in a big, bad way over the weekend in the ever-so-lucky Diamond Dallas Page, now in the lethal lottery.
Well, what comes around, what goes around comes around. You know, this man, Diamond Dallas, has always been a credit to
the sport. Like a cold sore.
And he's also been a credit to humanity. And for this man to be out of wrestling, for this man to be on the street, living like a bum, living like just living like a bum. He should not do that. He's back in WCW where he should be. The man's a credit to our sport.
Irish with a nice reversal by Chris Benoit. This guy is so rugged.
Boy, your opinion stinks. Do you know that?
Mine?
No.
Mine?
Heenan.
Oh, I was going to say.
About Diamond Dallas. That stinks. You know that guy's no good. You know it.
You got enough to worry about.
I understand the Macho Man, Randy Savage, is outside. He's got some cover.
Wait a minute. Macho's here?
He's here.
Good.
He's outside.
I want to go talk to him. I want to go talk to him.
Where's he going?
Where's he going?
Okay, now bolt the door so he can't get back in.
Steve McMichael. Here is it. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, is outside. Gene Okerlund's going to be trying to say he just bailed out of here.
Well, he took off like he had a message for Savage.
Oh, Dragon Suplex. 1, 2.
He got him.
He got him.
Now, is McMichael going outside to talk to Savage? Or is he going to the little boys' room?
I don't know what that's about. Steve McMichael bailed.
Oh, I know what it's about.
Symbols of excellence.
And you heard it from Chris Benoit, the symbol of excellence. Four horsemen.
Guaranteed one tough customer. Squire Dave Taylor, no slouch. Chris Benoit, very, very tough man. A member of the horsemen, knows exactly what to do. Set Mr. Taylor up. He was all Mr. Benoit's now. Takes him over backwards, that suplex. He's not going anywhere.
Coming up next, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, as he takes on VK Wall Street here live on Nitro. And I got to tell you,
where's Mongo?
Well, we're going to find out after this break. Gene Okerlund is going to be talking to the Macho Man outside the
field. Get a camera out there then. I'll go.
All right, we're back on WCW Monday Nitro. We are in Nashville, Tennessee. We are live, and with me at this time is the Macho Man, Randy Savage. He has been barred from the building. He is persona non grata here. And, Randy, I've followed you for your entire career, and in my opinion, the train's in town, in my opinion, you have lost it.
What's the deal, man?
Wait a second.
Wait a minute, baby. If anybody in the WCW can sympathize with what you're going through, it's Mongo, baby. Ric Flair, you done made a mistake now, darling. It's all right going out and getting your publicity on my behalf out in the front of the whole world, but when you come back in the locker room messing with family, baby, you made it real now, darling, and I'm going to do something about it. Macho, just chill out, baby, because I've got a plan.
All right, easy does it here. Just a second. Come on. Hey, you're not going to be allowed in there, Randy. Forget it. Yes, Doug Dillinger, please. I have business out here. Can we talk, as Joan Rivers would say? Randy Savage, I want to say it again. Come here, please. Don't walk away from
me.
You have lost it.
Lost what?
Your mind.
Let me tell you something. I'll tell you crazy. You ain't seen crazy. You ain't seen nuts. I'll talk to you in another lifetime, but not this one. I'm going to take the WCW and turn it upside down. You got it.
Well, as of late, upside down a little bit, but Randy Savage finds the Magic Johnson to Dennis Rodman. Those failures by comparison.
I don't care about the money. I don't care about the money. Do you understand that? Who said that? I don't care about the money. I'll reiterate that.
You understand that?
Don't tell me where I'm going.
No, because
you don't know where I've been.
Randy Savage.
You don't know where I've been.
You are going to have to coexist this Sunday. I was there when the gals drew the names of you and the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, as a team in the Lethal Lottery. If you want to get the Battle Bowl, you're going to have to make it happen with this man.
Wait a minute. I don't have a problem with that at all. I don't mind dragging a dead tag team partner to the ring.
You are out of luck
here. Because I'll win the Lethal Lottery, and I'll do everything I got to do to get where I got to get. You understand that?
I don't know if I understand or not. Please, Randy.
I saw a woman psychiatrist, and she said I was an OCD, one cool dude. You understand that?
All right, I should point out that WCW officials have told this man to seek behavioral help, whether it's a psychiatrist or some kind of counseling. I don't believe he has done it. Stay tuned. We are live in Nashville, Tennessee, and there is more WCW Monday Nitro coming up after this. Don't go away. Don't let him in there.